Hey everyone, I just want to say thank you guys for clicking on this video and even giving it a watch. I just want to kind of introduce what I'm going to be doing, what kind of series I'm going to be making. I'm expected to be making a history type of mini series. First, it's going to be the whole Sengoku Jidai period of Japan, basically the samurai medieval period. I'll explain more in the videos, obviously. But for right now, I don't know whether I'm going to be going through the entire eras in history. I think for this one, it deserves the justice because nobody ever talks about it. And there's going to be some incredible, spectacular stories that you've probably never heard of. So I'm probably going to be making two or three videos a month. I don't know whether or not, it might increase later on, but for right now, it's two or three videos a month. So I'll be covering the Sengoku Jidai period extensively and then moving on to other areas in history. So thank you guys and enjoy the watch.
The Sengoku period of Japan, 1467 to 1603. The Sengoku period of Japan, in my perspective, is one of the most epic and poetic periods in human history. Everything from social structure, social hierarchy, warfare tactics, armor, and weapons make this period so dynamic and romantic. The Warring States period, as it was called in English, basic breakdown starts with a massive civil war breaking out between rival clan factions in Japan, where the centralized shogunate or bakufu government at the time became unstable and ineffective in governing and regulating clan faction hostilities towards each other. With tens of thousands of lives lost during this period, historians attribute a high casualty number increase due in part because of first contact with European Portuguese settlers, or Southern Barbarians as they were called in 1543 Japan. This advancement led to the introduction and mass production of musket rifles and cannons, completely innovating war tactics and strategy during this period of Japan. This basically meant that medieval-style warfare was being infused with early modern warfare. Pretty Bamf. Old blood feuds between clans and province disputes also revived themselves across Japan during this period. Clans like the Iwagawa and the Oda ramp up their own wars, causing hellacious conflict in their own regions of Suruga and Owari provinces. This leads to decade-long wars in their own home territories, costing thousands of casualties on both sides. Sengoku Jidai is also recognized as a period where smaller clans took advantage of the weakened shogunate and propelled themselves to rise against the odds of fate and challenging the established powers that previously limited their growth, the philosophy or saying of Gekko Kujo. This period shows the brilliance, hearts and values of the samurai operating within the Bushido way, which is mainly why I wanted to do this series. The cunning, brutal politics and the evolution of Japan from a neighboring faction clans in all-out war to a re-establishing period in centralized government. This period truly fascinates me and excites me, and that is why I want nothing better to do than to rant about how fucking incredible this time period was and is in Japanese and human history. I want to establish context leading into the Sengoku Jidai period with situations and conflicts that set this period off. Let's rock! First off, the Ishikage Shogunate was the Shogun dynasty line in power during this era, from 1332 until the late Sengoku period in 1573.
The Shogunate, or the Bakufu government, which is the governing term for the Shogun's government, was established in 1185 AD to 1868 AD. The Shogun's role in Japan was to be the head military commander-in-chief, protecting Japan from foreign invaders and a preventer of military conflicts amongst other clans.
The Shogun would usually have a dynasty line, but on occasions historically, the Shogun has been appointed by other emperors of Japan. After years of effective centralized governing by the Shogunate and strong political ties created with the most powerful clans in Japan, smaller clans sensed that they were being disrespectfully treated and barred from prominent trade agreements. They became jealous and resentful towards the powerful centralized Bakufu government, and this bitterness would catch up with the Ashikage Shogunate in the beginning of the conspiracy, which would lead to decade-long war, destabilization of the Bakufu government, and a fortified castle town left in shambles. This story begins with the eighth shogun of the Ashikage clan, Ashikage Yoshimasa. Ashikage Yoshimasa wanted to retire from a stressful reign of being shogun, but had no heir and children to assume power. This led to Yoshimasa adopting his brother and formerly retired Buddhist monk Ashikage Yoshimi to become the next in line to become shogun. The following year, Ashikage Yoshimasa ends up having an illegitimate child to his surprise, which sparks huge debate in Kyoto on who is more of a legitimate candidate to become the next shogunate in line.
This raises the question, who will be the next shogun? The adopted Buddhist monk brother Yoshimi, or the new son Yoshihisa?
This is where the story gets crazy, as one of the biggest clans, the Yamana clan, begin to fall out of favor and conspire against the brother Yoshimi. The motive for this move was because the Yamana clan wanted a better political position that was closer to the shogunate, and they believed that would occur if they favored and championed the young son, Yoshihisa, as the next heir. Not to also mention that the eighth shogun, Yoshimasa, joins the Yamana clan in favor of his son as well. This causes the adopted brother Yoshima to call upon his biggest allies, the Asukawa clan, to defend him as the already proclaimed next shogun.
This leads to both armies,
the Yamana being the western army and the Asukawa being the eastern army, to raise over 80,000 troops each and battling outside and inside the city of Kyoto. This war became devastating as the clans brutally fought each other over control of Kyoto for a grueling 11-year period with no decisive victor. Eventually, the adopted brother Yoshimi became mentally affected from the war. He surrendered and went over to the Yamana's lines to plead with Yoshimasa to concede his claim to the shogunate and instead nominate Yoshihisa as his successor. This was only 2 years after the beginning of the Onin War, and now other sections of Japan are given the green light to also go to war and battle over supremacy. This war continues to rage on another 9 years because of other clans' involvement, like the emerging militaristic Buddhist monk society called the Ikiiki. The Ikiiki, being the badass warrior monks that they were, would eventually revolt against the shogun and his demands because the Ikiiki became threatened and ordered to pledge allegiance to what they thought was a disgraceful warlord, which caused further conflict in the Kyoto region.
With the regulatory body being the shogunate consumed in war and the Bakufu government becoming non-existent, clans begin to take the initiative to encroach on rivals' provinces in order to seize more power. In the end of the Onin War, the young son Yoshihisa gets named shogun and rules for 10 years, but dies unexpectedly at the age of 30 while campaigning against another smaller daimyo named Rakoku Takayori, who was seizing shogunate-owned lands in the Omi province. A crazy amount of social change was occurring for the upper echelon society of Japanese medieval culture. But with no winner and a dying structure, a new question was raised. If the Onin War was so devastating, how much more war until a new decisive shogun was named? And of course, them not knowing that this question would not be answered for another 136 years. Japan becomes a battleground for power. As for Kyoto, the capital city for the shogunate was left in ruins, and the shogunate's regulatory powers over the rest of the clans dissipated. Clan leaders became skeptical of the shogunate's legitimacy and decided to take arms and matters into their own hands, thus starting the Sengoku Jidai period of Japan. The Onin War's outcome for both the Asukawa and the Yamana armies was drastic, as both daimyos of the clans perished before the war finished as stress and sickness weighed on them. The invasion and civil chaos left Kyoto a looter's paradise, and the Bakufu legitimacy becoming more questionable with every passing day. Clans became warmongering states, and daimyos were willing to sacrifice anything to fill the power vacuum void left by the failed shogunate.